This is the bubble machine testing. Lots of bubbles. Bubble for falling. Two stream up there, and two stream on the east side. On this side. Okay. A lot of bubbles. A lot of bubbles. Okay, welcome to PyraPOD. This is a special event happening. What you see is my backyard PyraPOD build according to SolaRoof technology. I'm glad today we have the inventor with us. In fact, he's been teaching me all along, right? For how many? 6 months? Almost every day we meet. I learn a lot. I find I'm a sponge, and I find that I can learn a lot from Richard Nelson. It's been a pleasure to have him here, and it's been a pleasure to have everyone, here joining in. Let me just say something, and then I pass the mic to Richard. For those who haven't met me, my name is Aubrey Zhang. I came from China and came to study. Got my PhD in electrochemistry, but then I find it's boring to work with atoms. So I feel that it's better to work with people. So anyway, I did a lot of things. Eventually, one day I realized I need to use the solar energy, So that's how I started my journey with solar energy capture, and then eventually I joined a company. This company is trying to get Japanese OM solar into Canada. Basically, they use the sun to heat the air, make the air hot, right? And then use the air to make hot water and other thing, So we call it solar HVAC. But the problem with air is it won't, doesn't contain lots of moisture, right? Won't capture, it won't have the capacity, right, to capture this so much solar energy, right? So I met Richard Nelson, learned his technology. Actually, he's using bubbles, so bubbles give you both air and water, right? And then with this, and also it's dynamic, so I won't spend too much time, but I like to just pave the way for those who don't know about SolaRoof. I just say this. I'm sure all the one who was participating, you already know what is SolaRoof, right? So for that reason, I just pass the mic to Richard Nelson. Richard. Yes. While you speak, I'm going to translate into Chinese, because I'm doing this at the same time, both to the world in English and also to my countrymen in China, mm-hmm. who speak, who probably won't, some will understand English, but most,
all right.
Yeah.
That's wonderful. Yeah, we really appreciate that.
Yeah, and thank you.
Speak a little bit more slowly with some pause.
sure. Yeah, we're just
Translation.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yes, well, thank you for the introduction.
谢谢你的介绍.
And I think I should start by also introducing you.
Because, 介绍 Aubrey.
I've been looking for...
我一直在寻找...
To be able to... establish manufacturing for
寻找能够把这个我的技术变成商品化。
And every time you know I'm building a project, it's usually one a custom build.
Yeah, 每一次我帮助别人做DIY都是那种就是根据他的需要去建的。
And I've been around the world building these solar roof structures based on my own patents.
Yeah, 那我一直是在全世界各地来去帮助人来用我的技术就是独阳屋顶技术来建新型的建筑。
Which we have several countries where projects are built and many operational.
Yeah, 有好几个国家有一些项目而且是能够运作。
But then I came back to Canada.
然后我就回到了加拿大。
Looking to, you know, get some projects to move forward in North America, in the USA and Canada.
Yeah, 那我回来的目的就是要希望能够在这里，在北美能够有这样的项目能够进行。
And right at the right timing,
那在非常巧妙的时间，我见到Aubrey。
So the really exciting thing about the project we're looking at in Aubrey's backyard.
那我们现在看到的就是Aubrey的后院，他的一个项目。
Is that we have the capacity to replicate it.
我们有这样的一个能力，能够去能够复制这样的技术，让它可以去能够工作。
So then we're not just building one anymore, we're establishing PyraPOD business.
Yeah, 我们不是仅仅建一个，我们是建立了一个金豆荚的一个阳光产业。
Yeah, so this I consider this to be probably the pinnacle of my life work.
我把这个看作我的整个一生的一个工作的一个非常重要的分水岭。
And I would certainly say it's probably the most beautiful structure.
我甚至要说这是非常漂亮的一个建筑。
And there is a British philosopher called Schumacher.
有一个英国的哲学家，他叫舒迈克。
He wrote the book Small is Beautiful.
那么他写了一本书，就是小是更加美丽的。
So what we have is a design for every family.
那我们在这里呢，就是有一个为每个家庭可以来制造的这样的一个产品。
And it can go in the backyard.
那么能够在后院建立起来。But
actually, you know, we do have a family of design.
那么，但是呢，我也
show the PyraPOD
okay
catalog
catalog. Oh boy, I'm so busy
too large.
I'm so busy to prepare.
I know it's
something that I may not have the catalog ready. but
talk about it. Yeah, we have you know.
I can share a page.
Okay. Yeah, yeah, a page. Yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I can share this page.
Yeah.
This is actually where we have this. If you go to this, yeah, you know, there's manuals, right? Then here, pods for backyard use. See, I haven't updated yet. See, we only have PyraPOD 4, PyraPOD 8, but in fact, we have a full line of product, you know. Yeah, maybe you can name certain things. I try to open the 3D, right?
Yeah, you know, we can have a look at it whenever, you know, and I'll just continue to describe that.
Yeah.
What we want to do is to have these, yeah, I know you can't do everything because you're translating. so I want to have these choices.
Yeah, 我们就是希望给很多人呢有一些的一个选择。
For families and for communities.
为的家庭，也为的一个社区有一样的选择。
Which now we put a higher priority.
那么家庭我们是把它放的是非常重要的一个位置。
Yeah, then the industrial, then the large scale.
那么然后就是哈、啊、这个工业化的啊，那么商业化的产品。
Yeah, we can do projects at you know large scale.
我们是可以做非常大的啊，做的非常大的。
Which most 40 years is what I focused on.
也是我这40年之间一直是专注的，是反而是大的项目。
But I think that what we have is a calling to serve the, you know, the people instead of industry.
但是我们觉得我们有一个呼召，就是我们与其说要服务这个工业工业化的项目，还不如说回到家庭，回到那么社区。
Yeah, so you know, maybe there's questions, and you know, also what were your plans, Aubrey, to show the bubble machines working there?
I think I plan to show it at the end of it, you know, because I already showed you know, before, right? For those who came earlier, they already seen it, right?
There's the family of products.
Yeah, that's right. This is the earlier family, right?
Image, yeah.
Yeah, we expand. We add in more, right?
Mm-hmm.
Adding more to this, yeah. So,
One thing about the design now is that it's based on sacred geometry.
Yeah, 我们现在的设计呢是基于这个这个一种神圣的几何的形状。
You see, there's a pyramid at the center of all of the structures.
那么在所有的建筑里都有一个共同的特点，就是呢。有一个金字塔在顶端。
It's like the cap of the roof, which we see in the live stream image there of your project.
Yeah, 这就是我们在那个现在大家看到的就是这样的啊，都有金字塔。
There's a pyramid, and here in the sharing the screen, there's the family.
那在这里又看到了一个另外的一个系列。
So we went from a square footprint, which is very similar to pyramid.
我们就是开始的呢，是从一个方形的一个地基开始就是也是金字塔的地基。
And then we went to the octagonal.
然后呢，我们就从那开始就扩展到八角形就是所谓的金八。
So octagonal is the next progression.
那么这个八角形就是一个下一步的一个进程。
Also, you can see in these images a feature of the design.
你也可以在这里头看到那个我们设计的一些特色的东西。
Which is that we always have a lots of water.
那就是说非常重要的就是我们有这里头有大量的水。
The water is in the ground level or subground.
那么这水是在地面或者是地下。
So it's in a basement even.
甚至在地下室。
And actually, Aubrey, your project has that rock bed underneath.
That's right. Yeah. 我的后院呢那个就是我们特地挖了四英尺。做了一个特地人为做了一个人工那么水。
So why we have those features? In this one, you can see the basement actually.
我们为什么要用很多的水呢？在这里可以看到就是所谓的地下室有水。
And so we have these thermal mass, water thermal mass.
Yeah, 因为我们需要大量的水体来平衡来稳定这个温度。
Because the solid thermal mass are not active enough, they don't function properly fully.
因为这个固体的这种东西呢，它物质呢，它不容易吸热，不容易保热。
So we work with water in order to work with the sun thermal energy.
Yeah, 当我们要利用太阳能的时候，我们必须用水来去应对它。
And our walls and our structure are not massive. We do not need a massive construction like passive house design.
Yeah, 而且呢，我们的设计，我们的墙体不是像被动屋那样的要很厚的墙，我们的是没有，不需要那么厚。
And therefore the design is towards lightweight.
这样的话呢，我们整体的设计呢，就是比较轻。
And in fact, our PyraPOD domes, our products are extremely lightweight.
而且呢，我们的这个毒羊屋顶，这个就是金豆荚的这个毒羊屋顶部分是非常的轻的。
And then those insulated wall panels are also really lightweight and low cost.
那么下边住人的这部分呢，我们采用的一种模块化的这个墙体墙板也是比较轻的。So
what we're really looking for is a insulation property.
Yeah, 我们所寻找的就是关键的就是要去有足够的保热的这个能力。That
controls the heat loss and the heat gain.
那么有了这样的保热的能力，才可以有效的控制这个保热的效果，或者是湿热的效果。And
sometimes, you know, we want the heat gain, and we're going to capture it in the winter and use that.
Yeah, 有的时候我们需要这样一个吸收更多的太阳能，比如像冬天。And
sometimes we're going to avoid that heat gain and try to, you know, shade and reflect solar thermal energy.
那有的时候，比如说夏天，我们需要去不要这样，因为已经有很多的热量进来了。That
would be especially in the south, you know, on a very hot sunny day.
那么特别是像今天这样的，这么热的，那个晴天，我们就不需要那么多的热量，而且需要给它创造一点阴凉。
Yet in the winter in the north, we use the bubbles for insulation at night.
那么在冬天的时候呢，我们是北面的那面墙呢，要用肥皂泡来绝缘。So
we conserve the thermal gain.
这样的话，我们可以去把这个吸收的热量把它保留下来。That
we captured in the daytime.
就是保留白天可以吸收的热量。But
in the hot south, we use the bubbles during the day only, not at night.
Yeah, 我们在很热的时候呢，像南方，我们在南面是用一些气泡遮阳。Yeah,
since the we can radiate the thermal gain of the daytime out through the roof of the building, through the skin.
Yeah, 因为我们在实际上当它很热的时候，实际上可以透过这样的一层膜，可以往外释放热量，所以不一定总是保热。This
is because the night sky in those dry, hot climate is very cold.
因为在晚上的时候呢，它是。 那个外边的这个夜间是实际上外边是比较凉爽的，甚至冷的。So
you can balance the radiative gain of the daytime.
所以你 radiant
losses of night.
所以这样的话呢，你就可以利用湿热和吸热这两个平衡来去控制温度。
Now we also use the ground as a heat sink.
而且呢，我们也使用了地下的水来去做这个热储藏。So
basically, it's a dynamic system that can handle any seasonal requirement.
所以就是说，这是一个动态的一个体系，可以来去应对各种的情况，甚至极端的情况。
it's not specialized for winter performance or summer performance.
Yeah, 它不是专门为了冬天，也不是或者说专门为了夏天，它是可以这个冷热都可以处理。
Because we just change the operational process with the bubbles and the water.
因为我们就可以去来作为在泡沫和水的这两种状态做一个切换。
The bubble, you know, the bubble insulation, people can understand that fairly quickly.
那么用肥皂泡来保温，它实际上是很多人都能看到的，看懂的。
No, because the bubbles are quite visible.
因为这个肥皂泡是看得见的啊。
But the other process that goes with is almost invisible.
但是呢，其他的一些过程就看不见了。
We call liquid film cooling.
就是所谓的用液体的水来去降温。
So it's a thin film of soap liquid on the inside skin.
它是一层非常薄的那个水膜在这个内膜的里边形成的。
Pumping the soap liquid to the peak and let it flow down the skin.
很简单，就是把这个液体的，就是肥皂液呢，把它用水泵打到上边，然后让它往下流。
And then the skin temperature, the inside skin.
这样的话呢，内膜的温度
has the same temperature as our soap liquid reservoir temperature.
就可以使得内膜的温度和这个水蓄液池的温度是一样的。
So we may keep the soap reservoir temperature around 12 to 15 degrees.
我们在蓄液池的这个水温是保持在12度到15度之间。
Yeah, Celsius, of course.
那么这是东南方向的。
And so the skin temperature is...
这样的话呢，膜的温度。
And that creates a dew point temperature for the atmosphere.
那么就在膜的内膜的里边就创造了一个特别的露点。
We look at an enthalpy chart.
我们如果能够看这个熵的那个图画图片的话。
And we see that around a 50% relative humidity.
那么就是在50度左右。
Well, 50% relative humidity is very comfortable and very productive for the plants.
我们知道，当湿度是50%的时候， 那么人也感觉舒服， 那么这个植物也感觉舒服。
We then have about 10 plus degrees, delta T, 10 above the air.
Yeah. 这样的话，我们就可以控制在温度在上下10度的左右来波动。
So the air temperature could be, for example, 25 degrees.
所以这样的话，温度可以是25度。
And there's the graphic that we like to show.
那这个就是我们要分享的这样一个图片。
So this is a very, very simple process.
这是一个非常简单的一个过程。
And this cooling liquid on the surface is not cooling the great outdoors.
那么这个冷却水呢，不是冷却外边的。
You see it's on the inside skin.
它是在里边的，在这个内膜的里边，内膜的上边。
So it's the internal building environment that is in contact.
所以它接触的实际上是建筑物的里边的一个部分。
And it's the humidity in that internal air environment.
它改善的就是这样的一个空间，夹层空间里的一个湿度。
That humidity will condense on that cool inner skin.
那么借着这样的一层水膜，那可以去迫使这里边的，就是内膜下边的，就是等于就是这里头的也能够去冷凝降温。
And the liquid cooling film can flow underneath the bubbles.
这样的凝结的水呢, 它是可以在内膜里边去, 这个流动的。
And the bubbles themselves are also cool at the same temperature.
这样的话呢, 里边的, 就是内膜里边的, 就是夹层里的, 水泡也可以因此被降温。
So again, all the energy that is collected by this thin film.
那么借着这样的一个 非常薄的膜可以累积的那个太阳热。
It's coming from the inside.
实际上是从里边 来的。
So how much energy goes inside? The quantity.
那么你算一下 进到里边的那个热量。
We can calculate that easily.
我们可以去算一下, 非常容易地算出来。
Because we know the surface area of the PyraPOD.
因为我们知道这种结构的面积, 表面积。
We know the square meters of sunlight which come through.
我们也知道, 通过, 太阳光的辐射进来的辐射的能量是多少。
That's the radiant energy, sunlight radiant energy.
那就是, 就是, 太阳能的那种辐射的能量。
We know it's 1 kilowatt per square meter per hour.
那么就是每小时, sorry, could you repeat that?
Oh, 1 kilowatt per square meter.
1000瓦, 一,
per hour.
Yeah, 一平方, 平方米, 对, 对大卡。
So, you know, when the structure standing in the sun,
所以当这样的一种建筑在太阳光下立起来的时候,
it captures about 50 square meters.
能够 去接触的表面积大概是 50平方米。
And so we could say that we have 50 kilowatts per hour energy capture.
所以这样的话, 我们所吸收的就是 50大卡每平方米。
So all of that radiant energy that gets through, right, the skins, gets through the bubbles, gets through the liquid film.
那么这样呢, 这个我们吸收的这些, 透过这个膜进来的能热能,
all that thermal energy and the photosynthetic spectrum as well.
实际上还包括, 这个包括光合作用所需要的能量。
It's going to be received by the leaf canopy, the plants.
那么光就是除了热能的部分, 其他的就是属于这个, 这个植物所吸收的, 光合作用所吸收的能量。
And in this graphic, we see that the plants have the capacity to convert that radiant energy.
Yeah, 我们在这里的图里可以看到, 这个植物是可以把这样的能量转换的。
Kind of a miracle of creation of living systems.
Yeah, 借着一个非常奇妙的创造的, 设计, 那个能够去做这样的转换。
That in the visible spectrum,
那么就是在一个可见光区,
is very similar to the photosynthetic active spectrum.
那么可见光区就是非常适合, 这个光合作用所需要的那个能量。
That universities, including Berkeley, study photosynthesis and say,
那么以至于这个, 伯克利大学, 他们专门研究光合作用的, 这个团队。
They say it's 100% efficient.
他们说告诉我们是100%的有效率。
Every photon captured by the leaf,
每一个叶片所吸收的光子,
is converted by photosynthesis,
都可以用来参与光合作用,
into carbohydrate,
然后把植物变成, 这个碳水化合物。
Of course, that is a laboratory determination.
当然这是, 实验室, 给我们的数据。
in reality, there could be limiting factors like sufficient water.
那么在实际的场合下呢，可能会有一些的影响，因为取决于你给它的水有多少。
Sufficient carbon dioxide in the atmosphere there.
而且还包括二氧化碳的浓度。
Carbon dioxide is part of the formula of the conversion.
在整个的这个转化过程中，二氧化碳它是整个过程的非常重要的一部分。
But we can still say, you know, effectively, that the efficiency is extremely, extremely high in terms of converting the sunlight into carbohydrate.
那么，但是我们还是可以说，在现实生活中，我们 这种转换呢，还是蛮高的，效率是蛮高的。
But the other surprising conversion.
那么另外的一个转换，很奇妙的转换。
Is that what happens with the spectrum outside of the photosynthetic spectrum?
那么就是在光合作用之外的转换。
That's the longer wave radiation, we call it infrared.
那么就是所谓的波长比较长的这个所谓的红光的部分。
And half of the energy of the sun is in that spectrum, invisible, thermal.
而且呢，红光和红外，那么这个实际上一半的能量是都包括在这部分。
The heat radiation of the sun is absorbed by the leaf, and yet the leaf does not get warm.
那么就是但是很奇妙的就是，虽然有这么多的热能，这个植物呢，却可能还是能够不会烤坏。
Most people are unaware that the plants, like human beings and all animals, have a metabolism temperature.
那很多人可能不知道，植物本身它跟人是相似，它有一个转换的一个。 特殊的一个要求，一个温度要求。
Each plant has its own, specific temperatures, and from space, the satellites observe crops and can see if a crop is well or ill because of seeing small changes in temperature.
Yeah, 就是这个每个植物它所需要的温度是有不同的。我们在这个外太空研究哈，就是因为要在太空种菜，他们的研究也告诉我们这样的，就只要看温度的变化就知道它的变化。
But the typical leaf temperature is around 20 degrees to 22 degrees C.
那么植物的叶片它的温度大概是在20到22度左右。
Which is what we call room temperature. It's the comfort temperature.
这也就是我们所说的一个室内温度，就是我们喜欢的一个室内温度。
The leaf is cooler than the hot body, than cooler than the person.
那么这个液体的部分它是比我们的身体还是要更凉爽的。
So when you're in the tropical rainforest, the leaf canopy overhead is cool at 22 degrees. The forest floor is very cool.
那么，这个森林的那个植被的部分，地面植被的部分是非常凉爽的。
But the sun on the leaf canopy is the same as you have in the Sahara.
但是你叶片表面所感受到那样的温度，就好像是那个撒哈拉沙漠那样的情况，很热的。So
this mysterious mechanism that's little taught, it's not often discussed, actually.
就是这样的一种非常奇妙的一种的细节，很多人并不是在教导这个东西。
It's called transpiration.
这个就是所谓的一个蒸腾效应。
So we have photosynthesis and transpiration.
所以我们有光合作用，也有呢蒸腾作用。
The transpiration is equally efficient as the photosynthesis.
那么蒸腾的作用的这个效率是跟光转换的光合作用的效率是一样的。
It's the perfection of creation.
这是, 创造的完美。
Yeah, so when we know how much energy comes in, let's say 50 kilowatts per hour.
那么我们如果知道能够进来的这个能量, 比如说是, 每 50 kilowatt per hour? No.
Yeah, yeah.
50 mm-hmm. kilowatts
per hour, yes.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. 50,
yeah, with the surface area, right? The surface
yeah.
area.
Yeah. 我们说的就是表面 50千瓦每小时。
Oh, that's peak, you know, that's in the midday.
Yeah, 这是在中午的时候, 非常热的时候。
Well, different places have average kilowatts per meter per day, depending on, you know, the sky and how much cloud and different things, transparency of the air.
Yeah, 不同地方它的每天啊每平方米它的那个日照量是不一样的。
So it ranges from about 3 kilowatts per day to 6 kilowatts per day per square meter.
所以它是可以是在3000瓦每平方米到6000瓦每平方米。
And that of course is different as we go to the pole.
那当然我们到了如果到了南极或者是北极情况又不一样。
But you know, we're talking about you know, averages.
我们讲的是就是一个平均的每年平均值。
You know, some places in the North Pole can have more sunlight per year than in the tropics.
Yeah, 有些地方这个在北极甚至可以还得到更多的那个热量。
So the tropics have a more evenly spread light.
也就是说在雨季的这个地方呢它反而是比较平均的。
Well, so to, you know, look at the outcome though is that the moisture is being pushed into the air.
Yeah, 我们看到蒸腾作用使得这个水汽呢被发散到空气中。
It's by transpiration, and that is giving the cooling necessary to keep the leaf from warming up.
这也是植物本身的一个特点，使得它的叶片不至于温度很高。
So we know the phase change of water from its liquid to its vapor state.
我们知道这个水的特性，就是当它从水的液体状态变成水蒸气的时候所涉及的那个能量的这个转换。
And all of that heat energy is going into this process.
那么所有的这项能量都参与在其中。
So we can actually know approximately the quantity of vapor that the plants have to produce to stay cool.
我们甚至可以说，我们可以计算出，那么这个植物可以去有多少的能量的转换，以至于它比较凉爽。
It works out to about 1 kilogram per day per square meter of the leaf canopy.
1 kilogram per day?
Oh, wait a minute. No, I'm sorry. I was going from pounds. It's 1 to 2 pounds, 1 pound per square foot. Sorry, 10. Yeah, 10 kilograms per square meter per day.
Yeah. 就是要每天是每平方米是 10 kilogram, 10千克的水的转换。
Oh, let me correct, 5 kilograms.
对不起，我再纠正一下，是5千克。
So we collect a lot of kilograms of water because that humidity condensing is condensed continuously.
这就是我们为什么说用这种方法是可以得到很多的洁净水，因为 必须，因为它需要用大量的水才能完成这样的过程。
Yeah, and so the heat of condensation is given up to that thin liquid flow, the flowing liquid film.
这就是我们所看到的它的内膜的那个凝结的水，它流动的凝结的水啊，这就是为什么可以有凝结水产生的缘故。
So without any special effort, we have a water, we have a production of pure water from air every day.
Yeah, 所以我们不需要任何复杂的过程，我们只要搭建这样一种适合它凝结的一种结构，我们就可以产生大量的洁净水，从空气中产生大量的洁净水。And
we have a steady state humidity.
而且呢，我们可以使得它的这个湿度是控制在比较恒定的状态。That's
the relative humidity.
这就是一个相对的湿度。
Sometimes, you know, when I explain this, people think that it has to get very humid for this process to work, but that's not the case, right?
那很多时候我跟别人讲的时候，很多人以为必须要非常湿才会发生凝结的情况，实际上并非是这样。Also,
people worry that maybe the humidity won't go and condense.
Yeah, 那有些人甚至会很担心，这样的湿度可能就跑不掉，就是降不下来。
This is really physics, right? This is very simple, very simple physics. It's not rocket science.
这是一个非常简单的物理过程，不是什么火箭造火箭的高深技术。
So we're able to not lose the liquid that plants, the water that plants transpire. Because we do collect it.
这样的话，我们借的这样过程，我们就不会失掉很多的水分啊。就是当植物释放出这些水分的时候，我们又借这个冷凝，又把它回收过来。So
it's so much water. It's more. If you're growing enough food for people, you have like five times more water than they possibly need.
那么，当你要给自己家种菜的时候，实际上会产生很多的水的，实际上是大概是五倍的水。So
we have a closed H2O cycle, you know, we have a closed cycle.
所以这样的话，我们看到的就是什么意思呢？就是我们有一个封闭式的一个水循环系统。That's
the proper definition of regenerative.
这就是所谓的一个对 regenerative 这个可再生一个最好的定义。Sometimes
people use this word regenerative kind of loosely, thinking that it might mean the same as like organic or natural, but regenerative is actually a closed system.
那么很多人用这个 regenerative 就是可再生这个能源的这种术语的时候，以为它是什么跟有机啊、跟自然有关系，实际上它实际上是跟一个封闭体系有关系。So
if we take PyraPOD to Mars,
那么我们如果把这个金豆荚带到火星上，and
we put all our plants and our water and our carbon dioxide, we put everything inside.
我们把这个合适的二氧化碳水放在里边。We
put a person in there.
我们可以甚至把一个人放在里边。We
supply enough radiant energy.
我们是可以提供很多的辐射能的。We
don't need to ventilate the environment. We don't change the air.
很重要的是，我们不需要非要通风，我们不需要这个去要打开这样一个体系。We
can establish a closed life support system.
我们可以在那里，在火星上建立一个完全封闭的生态体系。So
all the carbon goes around the cycle. You eat food, you create food waste. The food waste goes compost.
所以这样。
所以这样的话，碳呢，它也是自循环的，这个你吃下去的东西，然后它又碳也有一个转换的过程。And then the carbon cycle, the carbon dioxide is gasified, is released from the carbohydrate.
那么植物在生长的时候，它会把二氧化碳释放出来。Which
is what we're doing also when we're breathing.
就是当人呐、动物啊，就是这一个啊，包括鱼，它就是 都是要这样的，呼出的是二氧化碳，吸收的是氧气。
We're taking our taking the energy out of the carbohydrate for our body.
Yeah, 我们借着我们吃这样的哈、啊、这个蔬菜，那我们就把这样的能量积蓄在我们的里边。
So the carbohydrate is a energy storage for solar energy.
所以我们可以这样说，这个植物就是太阳能的一个储藏系统。
It's a completely built into nature.
这是大自然里头一个自带的自有的系统。
So in the system, we're not looking for batteries, because we have energy storage, high grade energy storage.
所以我们在这里没有啊，不没看到电池，因为在这里已经有一个另外的生态电池，生态的储存啊，能量储存系统。
And we can do our anaerobic digester.
而且呢，我们还可以在这里头做那个无氧这个分解。
Put all the bio waste in the anaerobic digester AD system.
那么我们将这个哈、啊、所有的植物啊有机物都可以让它降用生物降解的方法来去回收它。
And those anaerobic bacteria produce biogas.
那么这样的话呢，厌氧的这个细菌呢，产生的就是沼气。
So we have a conversion to high energy, it's a high quality. It's not. So we have low grade thermal energy, right?
Yeah, 我们有这个低能的一个热能。
When we talk about that, you know, that's our heat storage or keeping it in the comfort zone, right? Keeping the temperature, humidity regulated.
Yeah, 我们所讲的就是一个简单的方法，可以使我们把那个温度啊达到一个适宜的状态。
And that one we work with the infrared of the sun.
在这样一个体系里，我们用的是啊这个太阳能的红光和红外光的那部分。
That's the heat source.
这就是热能的部分。
And we work with the ground heat sink.
就是热源再加上一个冷源，地下的地热。
The water heat capacity.
那么水的大量吸热能力。
And the sky heat sink.
那么还有呢，天空也可以去，也可以释放一些能量。
But the high grade energy is the short wave radiation.
那么但是高能态的就是更加高等的 能量体系，就 是 高频的部分。
Was a photosynthetic process.
这就是所谓的光合作用。
To a dense energy storage hydrocarbon, or
carbohydrate. 它可以把能量变成变成非常非常高能态聚集的方式，就是所谓的生这个碳水化合物。
And then we go from carbohydrate to carbon.
这样的话，我们在另外一个转换就可以把。Sorry. Yeah. 我们可以把它转回，把这个碳水化合物又转回二氧化碳。This is noisy.Sorry.
No problem. Yeah. And so we can go from that hydrocarbon dense stored energy, we can go to electricity, we can go to any other high grade form of energy that we really want, hot water, electricity, because, you know, you can use the methane, and that the biogas is energy dense methane.
所以这样的话，我们就从高储存能状态的，就是像这个有机质它实际上是把能量是高能态的高密度的把它储存起来，然后可以转化成沼气，我们就可以利用它了。
So in summary, we produce.
总结一下，我们生产的是什么呢
？All the food a family could require.
就是所有家庭所需要的食物。
More than enough clean water, which they can give back as gray water.
和大量的水,大量你用不完的水。
We're not losing any of that water.
我们没有失掉这些水。
And we have high-grade energy. We can have biogas.
而且还有高能量的聚集体,比如说沼气。
And we can run a fuel cell with biogas.
我们可以用这个燃料电池,用沼气来去驱动燃料电池。
That's the 21st century solution.
那是21世纪的一个解决方法。
But it's technology already certainly working and available.
但是这个技术实际上是早就有的。
But if you don't have the fuel cell, you can run a generator instead.
那如果你不用燃料电池，你是可以用沼气还是驱动发电机来发电的。
You know, running on the biogas as a fuel.
就是用沼气来做燃料。
So we produce clean energy every day, clean water, and organic food.
这样的话，我们每天可以产生大量的干净的水、干净的碳水化合物，还有沼气。
And it's more energy than we need for our own operations.
那么这些的能量都是我们人所必须的，而且是超过我们所需的。
So when we do our larger projects like the solar village,
所以当我们去转到更大型的项目里头，比如说太阳村，太阳生态村这样的大型项目。
Or the life pod for human habitation shelters.
或者是我们可以去建一个也可以住人的。
Then we can live off grid.
这样的话，我们就可以有一个办法，就不需要去利用电网就可以活着。Yeah. So as you can see, the liquid is running continuously.
Oh, yeah, that's right. That's
yeah.
Good.
And then that means once I turn on the fan. Mm-hmm. Right, I can produce bubbles anytime.
Okay.
Yeah. So, are you ready?
yeah.
Okay, I'm going there now.
From the outside.
Yeah, I'm here.
It's too hot. I'm walking toward the plug-in. Mm-hmm. I turn on the fan.
Okay. I don't see you yet at the site though. Eh? You're not in the camera view, I guess.
See, but now the.
Oh, I see you. I just caught a glimpse of you. Oh, there it comes. Okay, yeah, we see the bulbs. Wow, lots of them. Uh-huh. There we go. Mm-hmm. Yep. Mm-hmm, a lot of bubbles. Those machines, So two machines with two screens each on each one. And they will first of all fill one quadrant and then the bubbles will go at the base and they'll come up inside. And these are inside the building envelope. So of course, this is just a test, right? The cover material is not installed. So we're just testing the bubble machinery. See that it works. I think it's off now. Yeah. And right now we're just pumping from a barrel. In the future, you know, it'll be a really closed cycle. Obviously, this is not a truly closed cycle. Aubrey is still outside. You see a beautiful evening. We're close to sunset in Kelowna, BC. This is our location. This is.
Okay.
Hey, you're back.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh. So good. See, I can see, you know, well, you know, with this speed, right, I can fill up, 2 minutes?
Oh, yeah, you know, it was a little hard to see, you know, from here, but that's it's very good, you know.
I haven't crumped up the speed, you know, I'm using maybe, I think a quarter, you know, not the lowest, but
yeah.
It's, you know, I turn up, you know, quarter by quarter.
For the fan speed.
Yeah, for the fan speed. So I think I could make it, you know, faster.
Yeah.
But I don't have the, you know, I don't want to lose too much bubble, right?
No, yeah.
Too many bubbles, yeah. But in a closed system, in a everything, you know, cycle, then I can run really fast.
Yeah.
I mean, and also I'm using only one pump. See, this time at test.
And I see you kind of made a funnel to go back in those barrels, right?
Yeah. Because what do I do, right?
No, that's a good way, you know, to just gather the bubbles in the soap liquid.
Produce without using the fan. Actually, basically, I'm pumping, you know, the liquid up there. I let it fall. You know, as it fall along, you know, air join in, right? And then, so they are very fine, really fine bubbles, very sticky, fine bubbles. I love these bubbles. But anyway, this is something I worth recording. I, you know, this is actually what Richard did, right? Spray water, and then, you know, because of content of organic material and in the water, and then he got bubbles. Yeah, that's exciting.